Get us the pooches. Outside. Yeah.
This happens so, on the block.
You
want to
be a cowboy?
Day.
Hey, Mike, get your guns and meet me in the back right now.
Olehi. Everyone wants to be a cowboy. Grab your gun, boys. Olehi. 45 by my side, do he live?
You shot your bullet, but the bullet went.
Hey. Desperado.
New work for you, boy. I pull out my gun and blood two like true boy.
Why, Clef?
Pace one.
Yo, this is how the West was won.
Armado. A true desperado.
Rappers wanna be actors, so they play the Jesse James color car.
And get they bones fractured. You ain't got no guns, you off to the precinct. Some guys are feminine like shoes.
But Christ's son still died. Thrown off the building like the four guy. Caved in a grave cause you didn't know how to behave. Playing cowboy, not to sleep with the slaves.
This is just selling
bottles in the alley.
I'm NICEO CM, aka Godzilla. My older brothers wrote graffiti, so I started a little bit after they started, like in 1977. One day we was all in my house, we was just sitting around, drawing different names, and I did a block letter Nice, and everybody was like, that's the name I should start going with. Freedom Tunnel, I live in the neighborhood, so we always knew where Freedom Tunnel was. And some of my friends used to always go venture down there and walk around and take a look at stuff, but I never wrote graffiti down there. So I think around like 87, I started writing graffiti down there. Freedom Tunnel is unique to me because it's so long. It starts at 125th Street and it goes all the way down to right now 34th Street. So that's a lot of area to adventure around it and paint. Also, it's the quietness of the tunnel itself. I'm a leader of two crews. I'm down with four other crews. So I interact with people like every day, all day long. So a lot of times I want time for myself and I find going to Freedom Tunnel, I can find that time. It was real dangerous. At times it was nerve shaking. I actually seen someone get hit by a train and killed. Well, my challenge is this setback is always public perception, the cops, vandal squad. It's always gonna be you doing something wrong. And as you go bigger, the more hate you get. Tunnel. Freedom Tunnel is always gonna be the spot for graffiti because that's a place where it's quiet and most graffiti guys could go and they could do something and get whatever they need to get done without being interrupted because it's so big and it's so much space and it's hard to control that area. That's why tunnels are more important to graffiti writers than anything else, but some don't feel like that. I do feel like that. Freedom Tunnel started a lot of careers and a lot of people gained their respect and their art form from graffiti. This is how I grew up. It always starts with Vulcan, Zephyr, Lee, Scene, Bill Glass, Course, Scheme, Phase 2, Case 2. Those are the guys, my brother Slick, my brother Snatch, those are guys I always looked up to and I always try to cater my styles to. The advice I give to graffiti writers right now, study. Look at all kinds of style. If it's European, if it's American, study the style, even if you don't like the style. Study the style because everything you can apply to your style and that's how you build the style.
Excuse me, don't get old. I began writing graffiti back in 1974 and on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. I wrote for about 2 years and then I left home in 1978 and roamed around. So the Freedom Tunnel, which wasn't really the Freedom Tunnel, it was just the freight train tunnel. We went down there in 74, my brother and I and some other kids from the neighborhood, and we were gonna rob the freight trains. It was a freight train tunnel. And that was our big thing. And of course, at the age of 14, we had nobody. You know, it's not like if we found all these TV sets, we were then gonna bring them out there and then sell them for thousands of dollars, because we weren't in that world. But that's what we thought we were gonna do. I found this paint, and I had this idea that I would write "Freedom to Learn" in bubble letters on the school across the street. So I did that, and then they buffed it, and then so I did it again, and they buffed it, and then I continued to kind of do these little freedom aphorisms that were cute and amusing, and then it just got too long, and so then I finally cut it down to just freedom. Yep. And cut tape. Hi guys. Do you have a place to paint because of these shafts of light? So at the moment, you know, it clicks and you go, oh, that's great, but years later you really realize that, you know, after you build up a collection of them, the importance of that. Another one was when I used to draw the mole people, I used to get down there at about 6 o'clock in the morning, and they would all wake up and kind of come out and sit around and have breakfast around the fire and the paintings in the background and stuff like that. At the time, I was just determined to do the drawings. Some places were more dangerous than others. You didn't want to be that far away from the entrance. I never had a problem down there with any writers or anything like that. But I did have two or three occasions where gangs would roll through and they had guns and they would go down there to test off their guns. And then I would exit stage right because I didn't want to be a part of that. But I could just climb up into the rafters and they wouldn't see me. So they would think, you know, they would say, I thought I saw something, and then they'd look up all around and you could never find me. But there were others who were just so lost, who it was just so much easier to live in a little shed in the mud and stuff like that, because they didn't have to navigate what was going on upstairs. And then those guys would eventually kind of get swept out by 2000. But the initial move was 95.
Describe Freedom Tunnel in one or two sentences.
Describing the Freedom Tunnel is my life.
Freedom Tunnel, at its core, is quiet, dangerous, dirty, nasty, but one of the best places where you can find yourself in quietness.
All right. Thank you so much, man.
You're welcome.
Everyone wants to be a cowboy. Grab your gun, boys. Olehi. 45 by my side. Do he live?